Γεια σας and καλώς ήρθατε, which means hello and welcome in Greek, to another episode of Dimitra's Dishes. Today, boy oh boy, do I have a dessert for you guys. This is one that is just probably the best thing you'll ever have in your whole entire life. I know I've said that before, but this one is definitely up there. I had it for the first time formally, like from a dessert shop in Greece. Let me tell you first what I'm making. I'm going to make loukoumades with ice cream. It's like, it's almost like a Greek donut sundae. It's like next level dessert. If you've ever had loukoumades, they're basically Greek donuts that are dipped in a honey syrup. They're crisp on the outside and then they're juicy with that syrup on the inside. And you couple that with ice cream, and in Greece they drizzle toppings on there like Nutella. The Greek version of Nutella is merenda. Or you can choose your favorite syrups like white chocolate, dark chocolate, strawberry, and then they serve gelato over there. I don't have gelato, but I have second best vanilla ice cream. And you can top it with Oreos or nuts or whatever. But if you're just gonna keep it simple, really that's all you need, because this combination is amazing. And let's get started so we can just make these, because it's so good. We're gonna start with making the loukoumades dough, the loukoumades batter. So this is the same loukoumades recipe with just one small change. This is 1¾ cup of all-purpose flour. And the change is that instead of doing 2 cups of flour, which was what the original recipe called for, I'm also gonna add, or I'm gonna subtract 1/4 cup of flour, and I'm gonna do 1/4 cup of cornstarch, because it keeps them really nice and light and makes them a little extra crispy. If you don't have cornstarch, you can do rice flour. That works too. It adds a really nice crispiness to it. Then I'm gonna add 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar, a little pinch of salt, just 1/4 teaspoon will do, 2¼ teaspoons of yeast. Instant yeast will do, active dry will do, whatever you have on hand. I'm just gonna give everything a quick whisk. And then I have 1 cup of lukewarm water and 1/2 cup of lukewarm milk. I'm gonna add that. And 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract. And I'm just gonna whisk this all together until it's all nice and smooth. You don't need any fancy equipment for this. Now, if you haven't used your yeast in a really long time, before you put it in the mixture and do the whole thing, it would be a good idea to test and see if it's active. I used mine yesterday because I made a batch of these last night, so I know my yeast is active, but basically the way to activate it is just to put it in the water and the milk and put a little bit of the flour in there and a little pinch of the sugar and let it sit for like 7-8 minutes. And if it starts to form like a foamy cloud on top and it starts to smell really nice like yeast does, then you know it's good to go. You never want to use old yeast, otherwise this recipe will not work. And I don't mean old yeast, I mean bad yeast. And that's it. Once the yeast looks like this, there are no big lumps in it, and it's nice and smooth, it's gonna be a very thin batter. Then you're done mixing. Now you just want this to rise, so just cover it. This lid fits perfectly on top. I'm gonna cover it, set it aside for 1 hour, that's all it needs. And then in the meantime, I'm gonna make the syrup. Now if you're making this for a party, you can do this the night before and just put it in the fridge and let it rise in the fridge. It is gonna rise and it's gonna double in volume, so you could go in there and like deflate it every now and then, so that way it doesn't, if you put it in a smaller bowl, it doesn't come out of the bowl. You can also do this in the morning of your party and let it rise in your refrigerator, and then just take it out and let it sit at room temperature right before you fry it. So simple. You could even put it together right before your guests arrive and just set it aside and have it ready to fry right after dinner. Now what's next is the syrup, because you want the syrup to cool down before you start frying the loukoumades. So in my pan over here, I have 1 cup of granulated sugar. I'm gonna add 1 cup of water, and I also have 1 cinnamon stick in there. And I'm just gonna bring this mixture to a boil. Once it boils, then I'm gonna turn the heat off. You wanna make sure you keep stirring it so that way the sugar doesn't, you know, sit at the bottom and burn. Once it boils and all of the sugar is dissolved, take it off of the heat, and then you're gonna wanna stir in 1/2 cup of honey, whatever honey you have. Greek honey is the best, but if you can't find it, use local honey, that'll work too. And then just also stir in 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract, set it aside and let it cool completely. So all it takes is 1 hour for the dough to rise. It's gonna get really nice and light and bubbly. So right before you're about to fry these, you're gonna warm up some flavorless vegetable oil. I like to use grapeseed oil, or you could use a very light olive oil, like a pomace oil or something would be good. Heat that up to about 360 degrees Fahrenheit. You want to make sure that it's nice and hot, not too hot, obviously, because we don't want to burn them. But if it's not hot enough, then what's going to happen is that the loukoumades, the doughnuts, are going to absorb oil and become just gross, and you do not want that to happen. So make sure that it reaches its temperature. If you don't have a thermometer, then what you can do is either put a little bit of the batter in here just to test it, or you can put like a wooden spatula in here, and you're going to see that the bubbles are going to rise up to the top right away. That's how you know that it's ready. So keep it over medium heat. What we're gonna do is have a little assembly line ready. So we have our syrup, which is nice and cool over here. You do wanna make sure that it has cooled down to at least to room temperature. You wanna have a little bowl or a glass with water. I like to make my loukoumades with a little mini ice cream scoop. That is perfect. And the water is gonna help the dough release easily. You don't wanna get water in the oil. Make sure you keep that in mind. And what I'm gonna use as a topping today is chocolate hazelnut spread. I put it in this little piping bag right here. I'm gonna cut the tip off in a little bit because it's just gonna be so easy to drizzle it on top. If you don't have a piping bag, you can just use a freezer safe bag or a Ziploc bag or something like that. So I have some sliced strawberries. You can do anything. You could even chop up some of your favorite chocolate bars. You can make this as over the top as you want. You do you, it's your kitchen. So I'm not even gonna deflate this. I'm gonna take a scoop of this, and these are really nice when they're small. So they're gonna like double in size once you put them in the oil. So don't get them too big. Try to get them a little bit on the smaller side. Go ahead and scoop them into the oil. Do you see how they expand immediately? And as long as they stay on the top of the oil and they don't sink down to the bottom, your oil is at the right temperature. That looks good. I'm not gonna overcrowd the pan. At this point, I'm just gonna put my little scoop in the water so that way all the dough can be released. And I'm gonna fry these until they're golden all around. You don't wanna rush it and you don't wanna leave them in there too long, but you want them to get a really nice golden color. And that happens quickly. It really, the whole thing takes about two and a half minutes. So you're gonna wanna flip them around once one side is golden. And I like to use this, I think it's called a spider strainer. I don't know. I'll link it in the blog post if you want to get one. I got mine from Amazon, if that even matters. We are almost there. These are almost done frying. Let me tell you that you can also flavor the batter if you want to get creative. You can put whatever flavorings you want in here. You can throw in some cinnamon. I have done some apple loukoumades in the past, if you want to check that recipe out. You can put some cardamom seeds in here. Really, you can flavor them however you want. This is the traditional way to do it, the classic. There's really not much going on in there because they're so good as they are. But let me know how you're gonna make them in the comment section down below. If you're ever in Crete and you go to Chania and you go down to the port during the evening time, there's a little shop in there called Loukoumadaki, and they make the best loukoumades sundae that you'll ever have. Their loukoumades are bite-sized, and then you get to choose what gelato flavor you want. I'm drooling. So now when they reach this beautiful color right here, you wanna scoop them out and get as much of the oil out as possible. And then you wanna take them and transfer them into the syrup. And then go ahead and toss them around in the syrup so they can get nice and soaked and get all that flavor. And then take them out and transfer them onto a plate. And just like this, the loukoumades are ready to be served. You can sprinkle some sesame seeds on top. You can put some ground almonds on top and a little bit of cinnamon and serve them as is. But we're going to take this to the next level. I'm going to continue to fry these, and then we're going to serve them with some ice cream and toppings. When you go to put it together, then you want to do it this way. This is the way they serve it. Now I'm putting it in a trifle bowl, but you can serve it in anything that your heart desires. I wish I had those long little carnival plates, whatever they're called, those serving dishes. Put the loukoumades on the bottom, your favorite ice cream over them so it can melt over them and just create almost like a sauce on the bottom. If you want to put fruit, I put some strawberries on top. And then I drizzled some hazelnut spread, chocolate hazelnut spread. You can use merenda, Nutella, whatever is your favorite. Let me take a bite first of the loukoumades. Oh my God. They're crisp on the outside, super juicy on the inside. They're like a dream come true. Just a few simple, inexpensive ingredients create such a delicious dessert. Perfect for parties. Takes just a few minutes to put it together and a few minutes to fry it up, and they're ready in no time. Now it is time to take a bite of this goodness. Even though it almost looks too pretty to mess with. Almost. Oh my God. So good. You get the creamy ice cream that's melting over those, I keep calling them doughnuts. Layla calls these doughnuts, but these are loukoumades. The ice cream is melting over the loukoumades. They're so juicy and delicious. So good. I would even sprinkle or dust some cinnamon on top of this. Take it to the next level. The recipe for this is in the description box down below. If you want to learn how to make more delicious Greek desserts, click on this annotation right here, and I will see you right over there. Thank you so much for spending time with me today. I'll see you all next time. Yes, us.